Hi everyone, it's Asia here, Lemon Creation, and new art journal page. And this time I think I'm somehow evolving and doing something completely different. This art journal page is actually a leftover of other art journal page, to which videos you're gonna see soon, quite soon. I'm using a Lindy skunk sprays, squirts and shakers to add color to the page. This time no negative space, so that's why I said this is a different project for me. I'm evolving a little, I think, and I wanted to do something magical. I love fairies and all of that, and I said why not try and do something. So I'm using mixed media paper. I spray it from both sides so like that I don't have too much warping, because I am adding quite a lot of liquids, quite a lot of water, so much. So I had to actually, in order not to waste all, make a second print. And this is what I'm gonna actually use for this project. The second print, which you just see below. The first page I will use in the next video. And I actually, to the first page, I add some other colors, so it's different if it comes to colors. But this one will stay like it is. And I am adding now Nico Azul Gold, some splatter, and also a chipboard from Scrapiniec, which I will emboss with Imperial Crown Purple and Aurora Amethyst from Lindy's Gang. And I will do my my favorite. How do you call it? How I call it, rather, layered embossing. You will find the full list of products I used in this video in the description box below. And also I wanted to tell you, I haven't had a chance until now. I started to work with affiliate programs, which means that basically for some of the products I use, you're gonna get a link to the shop where you can buy them, or the products which are very similar to the ones I used, which can be a replacement. And if you click on the link and go ahead with the purchase, I will get some small percentage of the fee at no cost for you. I would just like to participate in the family budget, so I'm trying to do just that. But as I said, you will not pay for that. So, but I wanted to just tell you, so you know what the links are for. And while I'm talking here now, I'm doing this layered embossing of mine. So I use already those two embossing powders. And now I'm adding the third one because I wanted to have a little bit more contrast. So I wanted to do it nicely with some kind of a tool, but I've noticed that with a tool I have less control than with my hands, which is always the same case. I don't mind having hands dirty when I create, as long as I can clean them afterwards, and that's it. So I dip my fingers in the jar and I add a little bit of powder. So the trick is to heat up quite well the already melted embossing powder, take the heat tool away, sprinkle the other powder on top of already very hot first or second layer, and then heat set again. And that's the end effect, and I absolutely love it. The next step is to, of course, add some stamping. Cannot live without that. And so I will be using this beautiful new set from Maremi Small Art, Marta Łapkowska. The set is a little grungy, but there are some stars in it. And of course, knowing me, I couldn't just not use the stamps. And for this set, I really, I just cracked completely. So first I'm adding the stars. I'm using Tweens from Stamperia, so this is like a copper color and golden color. I used the copper one, but the stars were almost not visible, so I decided to actually add a little bit with a jet black ink. Because I wanted to have a different density of color, the first print I did on the scrap paper, And then at the very end, I added three small prints with the first print on the actual page. So like that, I have the different density of stars. And of course, I, as I said to you, I absolutely love this stamp set. And even though I was thinking this border when I'm using, which I'm using right now, it's the size is perfect for the page. I was not sure if it's not too grungy for this theme, but I couldn't help myself, and so I have to stamp it. The first impression I've done, it was not very crisp, so I redid it, as you can see right now. And this page actually will be glued with the 3D, no, not with 3D, with double-sided tape into my art journal page. This is the photo I printed out. You can, if you follow me and you look at my community tab, you can get there a link to the free photos which you can use without any attribution required. So that's what I do. I print out photos. I fussy cut them and then I use them for my projects. The acetate wings from Tim Holtz, I absolutely love, and thank you so much my dear friend Martina who sent me some of them, because I had another version of acetate wings but not this one, and I really like them. And so as you can see, I'm gluing my how can I call her, I don't know, she's like a fairy queen, I think, a little with a 3D foam tape, and on the bottom with just a tacky glue. Meanwhile, I forgot to actually glue the circle, the chipboard. And when you use the photos and you don't have a laser printer, you actually supposed to, or you should use the some kind of a tissue or fabric to not to get the traces of your fingers on the photo, because you can waste the photo very easily like that. And so I decided in the places when the glue ran a little bit over, I'm gonna sprinkle over that glue a little bit of, how do you call it, glitter. Oh my goodness, today is very, very hard for me to speak, I have no idea why. So I did that, but I've seen that the glitter didn't hold very well, so this is my trick also. Very often to protect my pages, I use simply a hairspray. And sometimes if I want to glue the glitter, which happens very rarely because me and glitter, I love it, but I don't like to use it. But when I want to use it, I spray the hairspray over my page or over the place I want to add the glitter. I add glitter. Sometimes it's also good to spray again on top. So like that, you know, you protect the page. You can either have a fixative, which will cost you a lot, or you can just try to save and on money and use hairspray, why not? I do that, I prefer to save. I don't need to have a you know, very good products, especially that the things I'm doing, they are just my art journals and I don't sell them. So for things which I know you would sell, I would use good quality products, but for something which I can find easy and effective replacement, I prefer to do just that. And so as you can see, I add a sentiment from 7-Dot Studio. I put it on the black cardstock paper, and I was thinking to leave the edges, the black edges sticking out, but then it did not really match with my page because I don't have that much black. So I cut the edges, I cut it on two sides a little bit too much, so I use archival ink, or StazOn in this case, to add a little bit of this color onto the left and right side of the sentiment. And now I am adding my glossy accents, because I absolutely love glossy accents also, I think they are magical, and this is magical page, so you know, I have to have them. And even though I inked the edges before, I'm adding some glue, and then I'll add a little bit of glitter again. My house is covered in glitter now. I know that for 1 week there is gonna be probably glitter everywhere, and my husband is gonna go completely crazy. But that's the thing, that's the perks when you live with the crafter. And that's this page is gonna go on the cover of my art journal, well, inside cover. And I wanted the edges to be black, so I painted the card, well, not the card, the cover, as you've seen, with the black acrylic paint. And this is it. No negative space, no white this time, a lot of glitter, a very magical, I think, page, a little bit of, well, it's actually very me. It's a hidden me. I hope you like it. If you do, leave me a comment, subscribe, share this video. I wish you a beautiful, beautiful and, of course, magical day. See you in my next video. Bye-bye.